What's going on, everybody? Welcome to a new video. In this one, I want to talk about what I think is probably the most improved defense going from Madden 18 into Madden 19, and that is going to be literally just the stock standard cover 3, and I'll go ahead and tell you guys why I think it is so much improved in Madden 19. So, to start things off, you have to know, over the past few years, there's been a very dominant route concept. You see I'm in Gun Bunch, and it's out of a play like this. So this is Gun Bunch, Z Spot and Go, Corner Strike, also very, very popular. But it all centers around Ted Ginn and Josh Hill running that corner flat combo. And now, in years past, to try and slow down this combo, you would pretty much need double flat zones out there. You'd need one to guard the corner and one to guard the flat. So you would have to do something, you know, along the lines of this, where you try and go ahead and have like a double flat, so maybe a hard flat, curl flat. People would go with, you know, hard flat, cloud flat, stuff like that. But point is, you need to allocate two guys to the sideline to try and stop this route combination in years past. If you didn't want to go ahead and sacrifice guys in the middle, this makes it more of a cover three Mabel style look. If you don't want to sacrifice guys over the middle of the field, then you're going to have to go with something, you know, where you get very, very risky. And maybe do something like this, where you basically don't have an outside third on that outside, go all in trying to stop the flood to the corner, and basically if they end up fading a guy or, you know, streaking Meredith and motioning him out, you're kind of, you know, in deep water in terms of you're going to get burnt deep. So this year, what you're going to see is now that cover three, that outside deep third, the guy that I'm on right now actually, is going to be able to play this route concept so much better than he has in years past. So what you're going to see here at the snap of the ball is how much better he reacts to that corner route than he has in years past. So you see flood to the right side, and notice how he's all over it and he doesn't allow it to basically develop underneath him. He doesn't instantly bail because there's no guy who's threatening to beat him deep. So in this case, he plays it correctly how they would in real life. He wouldn't just sprint backwards in real life if there's no threat to him getting beat deep. So you're gonna see here, right here, the curl flat takes the flat zone, or the flat route rather, even though he's not in a hard flat, he notices, okay, this is the guy I have to worry about. So I'm gonna sit underneath on the flat, and you see the corner route, you see how Xavier Rhodes on this side of the field isn't completely turned and bailing. In years past, he'd be way back here, basically with his back turned to the quarterback. Now, he's squared, looking at the quarterback, seeing that Ted Ginn's running that corner route. You have the linebacker as well, sees that's the guy I gotta worry about, I'm gonna run with him. And Xavier Rhodes is all over it. So you have completely bracketed coverage. And you're gonna be able to see, I didn't even get the ball off right there because I wanted to show you guys kind of how it looked. But if I do try and go ahead and throw this pass to Ted Ginn, Xavier Rhodes is going to make a nice reaction on it, and basically a lot of times if you have a nice cornerback like a guy like Xavier Rhodes, they're going to jump it and have a good shot at an interception. So you can see right here, completely plays it very, very well right there. Ted Ginn makes a tough catch in traffic, right as I say, that this pass is very hard to complete. But you can see it's much more difficult in a much tighter window than it has been in years past. You don't really feel great about that. As you can see right there, Xavier Rhodes had an easy shot at a pick, opted for the swat instead. But the only way you're going to be able to throw this route concept now against cover three is now by allocating another guy like Cameron Meredith to be the clear out guy. So the reason this is important, obviously this type of flood should work, right? Because you have a guy to carry him deep. Now, since he's being cleared out by Cameron Meredith, now Ted Ginn can work into the open space. The point is, though, is that now having to send a clear out route really limits your options, because last year, you know, guys, you would have, you know, the corner flat combo on one side, corner flat combo on the other side, and then you'd have room left over to have a drag or an in route or a slant, something to check down over the middle to, a playmaker hitch, something like this. So now with having to allocate three guys to run this offensive flood, it really limits your other options. And so that's why the cover three this year is so much better than it's been in years past, because now finally that outside third zone reacts to routes that are forming underneath him. As you can see right there, I couldn't even get the ball off, but he reacts so much better to the routes underneath him, doesn't just instantly bail for no reason when he's not being threatened deep, actually looks, identifies the play, and tries to make a play on, you know, the nearest route that's threatening his zone. So that is pretty much the biggest reason why I think cover three is so much better this year than it has been in years past. It's been massively improved in my opinion. Whenever you get massively, you know, a massive improvement against what was the most dominant route concept in the game for several years now, that's always going to bolster, you know, how good a defense is. And so cover three now might be the best defense to go against route concepts like this, and that is why it has been super, super improved in Madden 19. But that's going to do it for this video, guys. As always, thank you so much for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed. And until next time, take it easy.